Welcome to Kids Church Online.
We're so glad to have you here.
Go grab your family
and come and join us.
Even when his people are unfaithful.
Here are today's announcements.
Preteen Zoom calls are at Saturday at 5 p.m.
If you need the Zoom link, contact Caitlin. Her email will be right here.
Hey parents, we need your child's information, their full name and their birthday. Please contact Crystal down below.
We have Father's Day devotionals.
If you would like to receive it, please contact Pastor Crystal down below.
Yes, sir?
I have a question for you.
What's your question?
How many books are in the Bible?
66.
Why is there so much?
Because there's so many things to share.
Why are there so many things to share?
Because there are so many amazing things that have happened.
Why?
Because God is so amazing.
Why is he amazing?
I don't know. That's just how God is.
Why?
I don't know.
Why don't you know?
I don't know, Sarah.
Hey, Kizia.
Yes,
why do you... How much people are in the Bible?
There's probably a lot of people, but I have no idea.
Can you answer it for me?
I don't know.
Why?
Because I don't know.
Why?
I don't know.
Why?
Hey, why did people be so mean to Jesus while he was about to die on the cross?
I don't know. You should probably ask Pastor Crystal that.
Why?
I don't know.
But why?
I'm not sure. You know what, guys? There's Caleb over there. Why don't you guys go ask him?
Okay, Caleb, why?
Caleb, we have a bunch of questions for you.
I bet these questions are awesome, but you should ask Pastor Crystal on her Why series.
Okay.
Next month.
Why?
That was easy.
Why was that so easy for you?
Mm-hmm. Happy June, everybody. We are taking a look this month at the Minor Prophets, which are the last 12 books of the Old Testament. Today, we are taking a look at the book of Hosea. Hosea teaches us about God's mercifulness, even towards people who have run far away from him. He calls out to them to return to him, to repent, and to seek his face. There will always be consequences for sin, but God's love never fails.
For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourselves, it's a gift from God.
Ephesians 2 verses 8.
Good morning, kids. Today we will be talking about grace using ducky and monkey. Ducky and monkey are both average kids. But one day, both of them get in trouble. They both get caught cheating on a test. Let's see how that affects them. Monkey, however, will have something different. He will have grace. So, let's see what happens. You see, right there, that is Ducky. When he realizes he cheated on a test, sin causes him to fall off this cliff. Ouch, Ducky. Well, now let's take a look at Monkey. But fortunately for Monkey, Monkey has grace. And that is the big plastic bag. Let's see how he does. That was a softer landing. Well, you see kids, grace is like that. It's not that it completely removes the effect, because Monkey did still have to fall. But God gives us grace so we don't have to take the full impact of sin that happens to us. Unlike Ducky, we won't have to faceplant flat onto the ground, because with God we have grace all the time.
Hi boys and girls. Our story today is from the book of Hosea, Hosea 1-14. Hosea was a prophet. God gave Hosea a message to tell to the people of Israel. In addition to God's message for Israel, God also gave Hosea instructions for his own life. God told Hosea, "Go and marry a woman who will not be faithful to you, and be a father to the children she has with other men." God was going to use Hosea's life to show his people in Israel what they were like. Hosea's wife would love other men instead of Hosea, just like the people of Israel loved and worshiped other gods instead of the one true God. God was asking Hosea to do something very difficult. It's hard to love someone who doesn't love you back. But Hosea obeyed God. He married a woman named Gomer. Gomer became pregnant and gave birth to a son. And God told Hosea, "Name your son Jezreel." The name Jezreel had a special meaning. It would be a warning to Israel that they would be defeated by their enemies. Next, Gomer had a daughter. God told Hosea to name the baby Lo-Ruhamu, which means no mercy. God wanted the people of Israel to know that he was not going to show them mercy anymore. They would get the punishment their sin deserved. Then Gomer had another son. God told Hosea to give him the name Lo-Ammi, which means not my people. God's message to the Israelites was that they were no longer his people. When God rescued the Israelites from Egypt, he made a covenant with them. He told them, "If you obey my commands, I will make you my people and I will be your God." But God's people had broken the covenant by not obeying him. Gomer was not faithful to Hosea. Even though she was his wife, she often ran away. In the same way, God's people said they were committed to God, but they turned away from him. They worshiped false gods. Hosea might have given up on Gomer, but God told Hosea to go after her. So Hosea found Gomer and paid to get her back. He brought Gomer back home. "Stop being unfaithful," Hosea said. Even though Gomer had not loved her husband, and only her husband, like a wife should, Hosea loved her anyways. God gave Hosea a love that would never give up. God wanted the people of Israel to hear about Hosea and his wife and understand that Israel was no different than Gomer. Israel did not love God and only God like God's people should, but God loved Israel anyway. God loves with a love that never gives up. Hosea gave Israel God's message. He warned them that God was going to judge them for their sin. Hosea pleaded with Israel to turn back to God, to know and love him. "Come, let us return to the Lord," Hosea said. "Let us strive to know the Lord." God's people were unfaithful to God, but God is never unfaithful to his people. God said the number of the Israelites will be like the sand of the sea, which cannot be measured or counted. And in the place where they were told, "You are my people," they will be called sons of the living God. God was going to punish the people for turning away from him, but he would keep the promise he made to Abraham. Abraham's family would be a big family, and one day Jesus would come from Abraham's family. Yes, God still loved Israel. God hated their sin, but he loved his people so much that he was going to bring them back to himself. Just like Hosea paid a high price to get his wife who didn't love him, God had a plan to get his people back no matter what the cost. Hosea's relationship with Gomer reminds us of God's relationship with the people of Israel and with us. even though God's people are unfaithful and love other things more than they love God, God still loves us. God sent Jesus to die on the cross for our sin and bring us back to Him.
Point number one, God is faithful to His people even when they are unfaithful. In the book of Hosea, God uses Hosea's marriage to represent His love for His people. Hosea's wife was unfaithful. She continually ran from Hosea and forgot about His loving care for her. She had chased other people, but Hosea went after her and brought her home. We are so much like Hosea's life when we chase after things in the world rather than chasing God. God loves us and intimately cares for us. He provides for us, protects us, and is completely faithful to us. Hosea didn't ask his wife to change, to earn his love, but rather, his love for her was meant to change her. That is how Jesus loves us. Jesus did not say, "Clean yourself up and get yourself on track to earn my love." Instead, he says, "I love you so much, I died on the cross for your sins. Don't reject my love. Give me your heart, your whole heart." Does God have your whole heart today?
Point number two, God disciplines His people when they are unfaithful. So when we look in the story, it talks about how the Israelites were unfaithful to God. They were kept making bad decisions and kept choosing sin over God. And God warned them if they continue to choose sin, that they would have to face judgment and He would have to discipline them. So sin has been building up for so many years. Like, it has been building and building and building. It's like when we have a room and it's really messy and it just kept on piling and piling up with clothes, socks, and all of this dirty stuff that we have in our room. It's like that. Just like that, the Israelites have continued to sin and sin over these years that it just kept building. So sometimes it's easy for us to make bad decisions and make mistakes. And we think that we won't be able to, you know, it'll be easy for us to get away with. But God sees the truth. And sometimes in life, God does discipline us. So we know that we have to turn to Him when we are starting to choose sin over God. So the truth always catch up to us. And that is something, boys and girls, that even though sometimes it's hard to be tempted with sin, it's good to know that God does forgive us. But then it also knows that God does also help us in that time of need, because He's so faithful to us, even though we aren't really being faithful to Him.
Hey guys, so for point number three, we are going to be talking about how God has a deep affection for His people. Before we continue, the wind is a little bit strong. I don't know if it comes through the video, but if it does, I'm really sorry. But yeah, God has a deep love for His people. He loves them so much. He loved Israel so much. But the people of Israel weren't listening to Him. They were living in sin, they were disobeying, they were not making good choices. And because of that, God used the prophet Hosea to warn them, to say if they continue to sin, they continue to live like this, they're gonna face a lot of judgment. And you know, it didn't make God happy to see them in judgment and to see them facing this punishment that God had to deliver on them. It actually made God really sad. And what's more is that if it wasn't actually the sin, it wasn't actually because they were living in sin, it was because they weren't repenting. The sin was bad, but God forgives. God wanted to forgive them. They just weren't saying sorry. They weren't asking God for forgiveness. They weren't recognizing that what they were doing was wrong. They chose to live like that, and that wasn't okay. And you know, the book of Hosea, at the end, there's a story that comes out, and that God is depicted as this loving father. You guys know the song, Good Father? It's like that. God is a good father. And He had a son, Israel, and he was turning away. God taught the son everything, but the son turned away and chose bad decisions, chose bad path. The son chose sin. But at first God was angry, but it was God's compassion that won out. And God loved the son so much. And in the same way, God loved God loved the people of Israel so, so much. And because of that, God promised them. God had hope for them. God gave them hope because God made a promise that God would restore them in the future, that this isn't the end, and that God had a plan to restore them. And just like that, when we make mistakes, when we maybe do the wrong thing or we sin, it's not the end. God, there is hope for us. God has a plan of redemption through Jesus. And because of that, we can tell God, you know, God, I'm sorry for the mistakes I've made. And because of God's deep affection and his deep love for us, he will forgive us. You just got to ask.
Cook up your pants and answer these questions with us. Question number one, how do we get to know God?
Question number two, why did God want Hosea to feel how he felt?
How can we remain faithful?
Question number four, how did Hosea feel when his wife left him?
Question number five, how would we feel if our friend didn't talk to us?
Question number six, how do you think God feels when we don't talk to him?
Do you have enough space for dancing?
Come join us as we worship together.
The greatest day in history. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Never be the same. No.
Hosea, we see that we serve a God of love and a God of wrath. Sometimes it's hard to understand the wrathful side to God. I am so thankful that God loved the world so much that he sent his one and only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins, so that we would not have to face the wrath of God. No sin is beyond his forgiveness. Our God is full of compassion and he loves you deeply. The final words of Hosea 14 tells us, "Whoever is wise, let him understand these things. Whoever is discerning, let him know them. For the way of the Lord are right, and the upright walk in them. But transgressors..."
I don't know what kind of
transgressions.
Oh, should I read that?
Just say transgressions.
"But transgressions stumble in them. Those who are wise understand..."
Crystal, your finger's blocking a little. It's okay.
"Those who are wise understand these things, and whoever is discerning knows them. For the ways of the Lord are right, and they are upright walk in them. But those who decide to continue in their sin will stumble." May we be wise and discerning and walk upright all the days of our lives. God is forever faithful to us. "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." John 3:16.
Hey boys and girls, so today we are going through the Minor Prophets, which is the last 12 books in the Old Testament. And we're going to start with the book of Hosea. And you may say, "Pastor Crystal, what does Hosea really have to teach me? Because I'm not ready to get married." Well, boys and girls, God wanted Israel to know how he felt about their wicked ways and when they started worshiping idols. So God told Hosea to marry an unfaithful woman who bore him 3 kids, and which he named them, which meant, he named them 3 names, which meant God plans, no more mercy, and not my people. But Hosea's wife was not faithful, so she left Hosea, which caused him a lot of pain, boys and girls. So God compared this pain to the sorrow he felt when Israel left him and worshiped idols. He loved Israel and he loves us, boys and girls. He wants to be with us, for us to learn about him. When we turn away from him, we don't talk to him or include him in our lives, boys and girls. He's very sad. He will not tolerate being betrayed, and when he leaves us, he will not claim us as his family anymore. That's why Hosea named his kids "No Mercy" and "Not My People." Leaving God out of our lives, boys and girls, is very dangerous. It's not fun. He is known as the light, and when we walk in darkness, we stumble. The only safe and rewarding place to be, boys and girls, is near God. Because not only does he know what's best for us, but boys and girls, he provides it if we are near to him. God said Israel's destruction came from a lack of knowledge. And boys and girls, we want you to be aware that he has a plan and purpose for your life. And we want you to understand what the Bible has to say. And God used Hosea to let Israel know how he felt and how sad he felt. So boys and girls, why don't you take some time this morning and think about it. Think about what you have done to make God sad. And boys and girls, Jesus wants us to walk with him. And he gave us a choice to choose him or not to choose him. But he wants us to choose him. And if you choose him today, boys and girls, we want to say a prayer with you. And when we pray this prayer, boys and girls, just so you know, like the book, the Bible says, people lack because of knowledge. And we want you to pick up your Bible and read it. If you have any questions, we would love to answer it. But boys and girls, we want to pray for you that God give you the knowledge, that God help you as you walk through the summer, as you walk through the last month of school, that he would guide you in the decisions that you have to make. So let us pray. Dear Jesus, forgive us for our sins. Help us to live our lives for you. And Father God, we pray, O God, as we read your word, that you would help us to understand, that you would help us, O God, to do the things that you have called us to do. And I pray right now for every person that's listening, that you, oh God, would help them this week, oh God, to understand the calling that you have for their lives, that you would be with them, oh God. And Father God, that we would make you happy in the decisions that we make, because Father God, we choose you. We choose you, oh God, to be the center of everything that we do. In Jesus' name, amen. So boys and girls, summer is almost here, and we know that you have questions about the Bible. And like they said today, that we lack knowledge, we are disappointed God. So boys and girls, we want to answer any questions you have about the Bible. So email me and we'll try our best to answer any questions you have. You can email me at Krystle, that's K-R-Y-S-T-L-E at rpcchurch.ca. I would love to hear from you guys. Have a great week. God bless you and be with you as you finish up your last month of school. See you guys.